So now I'm going to open up the Color Cube 3D LUT workflow. Now that the workflow is loaded, I'm going to go to the first page. First thing to do is we're going to find our meter. I'm going to hit Find Meter, hit Search, and we want to make sure we have blue-green LED selected, because that's the type of backlight technology that the ColorEdge monitor has, also known as GB-R. Now we're going to find our source, which is our pattern generator. We're going to select manufacturer EIZO ColorEdge monitor USB, hit connect. Once you're connected, the monitor will display a flat gray screen. So you really want to have a separate monitor running CalMAN when you're doing this process, even if it's just temporary. Now we're going to find our 3D LUT device, which is again the EIZO monitor. We will select EIZO as the manufacturer. Now there's two options here. Some of the EIZO monitors only have 1D LUTs. The model we're calibrating today has a 3D LUT. So you got to make sure you select ColorEdge monitor 3D LUT as the model and hit connect. Don't be alarmed if the screen is flashing and showing weird things while we're connecting. It's completely normal. We will go to next and we will set our targets. There's a couple different ways you can set up one of these monitors. If you're using it as a video device fed from something like an AJA or Blackmagic device, you would want to keep CalMAN in video mode, 16 to 235. If you're using this as a UI monitor for a computer, then you want to switch this to PC levels or full levels, which is the way we have it set up today. Now, since we are setting this up as a UI monitor, the standard for computers is sRGB. So instead of using BT1886, we're going to use sRGB as our color gamut and our gamma profile. Once we have our calibration standards selected, we will go to next. Now we are on our pre-calibration page, where we're going to measure what the native response of the monitor is with no LUT applied. Now remember, this might be pretty bad because essentially there's no correction happening and we're just seeing what the native response of the panel is. So all the other presets in the monitor, like the sRGB and Rec 709 ones, all those have their own 3D LUTs that are being applied. When we do our pre-calibration capture here, there will be no LUT applied and we're just measuring the native response. So don't be alarmed if it's really outside and not close. We will hit our Read Series button.
This part is going to take just a minute or two, so we'll come back once it's complete.
Now that our pre-calibration capture is complete, we'll go to the next page. Now we're going to see some red or green dots that are telling us if our display needs to be calibrated more before we apply the LUT. This particular display does not have any controls besides a backlight control when you're creating a 3D LUT. So even though the white delta E is higher than you would normally want, we have no way of correcting that. So the only correction that this monitor has is applying the 3D LUT. As long as your luminance is set correct, and ours is right at 100 nits, so that's fine, we can proceed to actually creating the LUT. We will hit the Calibrate LUT button. This page applies only if you have a 1D LUT in your display. Now this display is capable of doing a 1D LUT, but you can only do a 1D LUT or a 3D LUT. You can't combine them to do both. So we skip this page if we're creating a 3D LUT for this device. If you connected to it as a 1D LUT device, then you would do just this page and not the next page. Now we're going to create our 3D LUT. We will hit the AutoCal button, which will bring up the AutoCal dialog. The EIZO monitors are very linear and almost always work great with a lightning LUT, which is what we're going to be doing today. I'm going to select lightning LUT as a calibration type. We want to make sure that this is full range because we're using this as a UI monitor for a computer after this. And now we will hit the OK button, which will start the LUT creation process.
This process will take about 5 minutes. So we'll go ahead and come back when it's all completed building the 3D LUT and show you the results. It looks like our lightning LUT just finished, and now we can go to the next page to view the results.
So now we're going to run a read series.
And this is going to take just a few dozen readings, a color point, so we'll come back in a minute or two when all the data is collected.
Now that the measurements are complete, you can see we have very low delta E's. In fact, they're so low that they're almost not even showing up on our delta E 2000 chart. We have an average of 0.2 and a color checker delta E average of 0.5, and the grayscale is the same, 0.2 and 0.5. Most color scientists would say anything below 1 is imperceptible to human vision, so this is an excellent calibration. Since CalMAN has direct integration with the EIZO ColorEdge monitors and their 3D LUTs or 1D LUTs, after we created the LUT, it was automatically loaded into the monitor. Some monitors, example being the Flanders Scientific monitors, need to manually load the LUT using a separate cable. So CalMAN would just write the LUT file to our LUT folder, and then you would take that file and move it over to your monitor.